Warning: The Savage Nation contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised. And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, The Savage Nation, home of unprotected talk, borders, language, culture. And here he is, Michael Savage.
Did you shoot Kate Steinling, the lady who was down on Pier 14?
Yes.
You did shoot her. Mm-hmm. Where did you get the gun?
In the ground, when that's over there in the bench. Put my leg and then see the one teacher and then see over there something like that. That's only I hear the boom boom 3 times.
Boom boom. Boom boom, like chocolate. So let's see, he was shooting at sea lions. He found the gun. I'm surprised PETA hasn't given him an award. No, actually, I'm surprised San Francisco hasn't given Lopez Sanchez an award for culling the sea lion population. And I'm waiting for the mayor of San Francisco to give the illegal alien Mexican murderer a prize for culling the Bay of evil sea lions. So everyone's to blame. The sleeping pills made him sleepy. The gun was found under the bench. He was only killing sea lions, which is unbelievable because a violation of state and federal law. He should be arrested for that. Immediately deported for that, for killing sea lions. Not one word from the animal rights liars. But he kills a beautiful young woman in front of a father. The father tries to help her. The girl screams, daddy, help me. And she dies in his arms. And now the reporters from KGO television go there and coax him into expressing regret for killing the woman. I'm not buying any of it. He didn't find the gun under the bench. Any homicide detective would tell you that's rubbish. What do you have to be, Sherlock Holmes, to understand this is all a lie? Oh, no. He went there, in my opinion, with the intent to kill someone for a gang initiation. That's as highly likely as any explanation for why he killed this woman randomly. Don't tell me he was shooting at sea lions. That's number one. That's what I would investigate if we had a rational city. Listen, this whole topic that we're talking about is a topic I've been talking about for 21 years. We all heard the story by now. Even the most unconscious, dumb Democrat voter in San Francisco is saying, "Ooh, that's terrible. The man from killed that girl on the wharf. That's not good." But them right wingers are going to exploit it against all Mexicans. It's that Donald Trump who really is the bad guy. The reporters were nicer to this murderer than they are to Donald Trump. And let me tell you something else. They're nicer to this illegal alien murderer than they were to me. You don't know this, and I'm not going to make it about me. It's too easy to do because I've been on this topic since I began in radio. One book after another, I've talked about the alien invasion. One book after another, I've talked about the war on our borders. But the fact of the matter is, when I was on another local station in San Francisco, the mobs, stirred up by La Raza and the other hate groups, had a mob of illegal Mexicans and Central Americans outside the radio station demanding that I be fired because all I did say was, no, they're not dreamers and they don't belong in my country. They're here illegally. That was enough for them to demand I be fired. So don't think I haven't been on the front lines of this war for a long time, but what good has it done? So who is to blame for the killing of this woman, the murder of this woman? There's a lot of blame to go around, and we're going to play things for you, and you'll decide who's to blame. This is in Gavin Newsom's backyard. Gavin Newsom is no longer mayor, but Gavin Newsom was once mayor, and Gavin Newsom boasted about this being a sanctuary city, and we have that for you on tape. Nancy Pelosi, I'm surprised she hasn't gone to the prison to wash the blood off Sanchez's hands. After all, she washed the filth off the feet of the children who were brought in last summer. Wasn't she the one washing their feet? Why doesn't she go to the jailhouse and wash the blood off Lopez Sanchez's hands? Why doesn't Dianne Feinstein take some credit for this murder? Why doesn't the district attorney take some credit for this murder? There's a lot of blame to go around, by the way. And if you think San Francisco is the only sanctuary city, I'll have a list of all major sanctuary cities for you. And there's a reason that these cities, Anchorage, Alaska, Fairbanks, Alaska, Chandler, Arizona, Phoenix, Arizona, Fresno, California, Los Angeles, California, San Diego, San Francisco. I'll list all of them for you. Do you know why they have made their city sanctuary cities? Do you think the cynical, corrupt politicians who are robbing the treasuries blind in these cities give a damn about illegal aliens? It's because the tax-paying citizens hate their guts. The tax-paying citizens know that they're corrupt, no-good gangsters, and they wouldn't vote for them. So by bringing in millions upon millions of illegal aliens, the illiberals, who are all kept in power by non-citizen voters, do you get that? Do you understand what I'm saying to you? If it was not for the illegal alien voter population in San Francisco, we would not have this corrupt regime running San Francisco. Was it not for the illegal alien voter population in California, we would not have this corrupt government running the state out of Sacramento. The taxpayers know who they are. Go drive around San Francisco and see how wonderful the city is doing. Go drive onto the Golden Gate Bridge from San Francisco, as I do regularly, and see the broken roadway. They won't even fill a pothole. Go drive on Lombard Street in San Francisco and see why you need an SUV to drive down that street, because they won't fill a pothole. They're busy stealing the money for road work. It's the most corrupt city in the United States of America. Now, it's very easy to jump on this story and say that all Mexicans are murderers and rapists. That's absurd. We all know that's a lie, and let's not go there. It diminishes this crime and this tragic murder. It does point out, though, what a sanctuary city will do, because it's done it before. Now, let me turn the clock back in time for you, because several years ago, there was another very tragic murder in this sanctuary city. It was a triple murder. On June 22nd, 2008, Edwin Ramos, an illegal alien with a long history of violence, executed Tony Bologna, age 48, and his sons Michael 20 and Matthew 16 in front of their mother. Edwin Ramos thought one of the Bologna sons was a gang rival. Did you hear that one? Now, I was deeply hurt by that murder, and I raised money for Mrs. Bologna, which I sent to her a fund. I never got a thank you note. The lawyer probably stole the money. But that's a side note. Believe me, I've been involved in this a long time. You remember that one? Raise your hands if you remember the last illegal, sensational illegal murder story. I was on the radio June 22nd, 2008. Edwin Ramos, an illegal alien who, by the way, had been arrested for murder before and released. A gang member released by the city of San Francisco, right? Came upon this family, made a wrong turn in an alley, Tony Bologna and his sons Michael and Matthew. They made a wrong turn, and this piece of human trash executed them in the car. Remember that story? Ramos was a suspected illegal alien border jumper from El Salvador. And he was barred from deportation, even though he had committed a gang-related assault and an attempted robbery. Do you know who stopped him from being deported? It was then attorney, district attorney, Kamala Harris, who is now the attorney general of the state of California. It was Kamala Harris who did that. Was she punished for that? Did she lose her career for that? No, because she's part of the Willie Brown machine. She was then anointed to a higher position. The entire state is corrupt from top to bottom. There is no crime that can be committed that will ever be punished in this state unless it's loving the country and the flag. That's the only crime, and homophobia. Those are the only crimes that will be punished in this twisted upside down city. So there's a lot to talk about in the Savage Nation. And I want to go back to my writings on the war on our borders, language, and culture. In my last book, Before Countdown to Mecca, called Stop the Coming Civil War, it looks to me like I should revise it and take out the word stop. Because it looks to me like only a civil war can save America. They are at war with this country. Obama has flooded 125,000 Africans into St. Paul, Minnesota. Why would he do that? Why would he bring 125,000 Africans to St. Paul, Minnesota, when they don't speak English, they don't know what the culture is, they've never used a toothbrush, they've never used toilet paper? Why would he bring them there? What is he trying to do to this country? Why is he dumping most third worlders in white cities and white communities and white towns? You're telling me this is not a civil war conducted by this monster Frankenstein? You're wrong. So there's a lot to talk about here. And the only one saying it is Donald Trump. And of course, he's being smeared by the vermin in the media, that's to be expected. That's all they're capable of, those useless idiots, always on the wrong side of things. And then, of course, there's Romney attacking him, Rubio, the ice cream man, attacking him, Rick Perry attacking him, all of the jerks who would not come on my show. By the way, you know why they wouldn't come on my show? Because they knew where I stood on illegal aliens. And we know what they're worth. You know what they're worth? They're worth zero. They're less than zero. They are less than zero. Romney, Perry, Rubio. I told you who they were. And so the only one who stood up for him is Cruz, to his credit. He would not attack him. Good for him. If you've listened to my show, The Savage Nation, you know the importance I place on the preservation of our borders, language, and culture. And you know that this administration has done more to further the left's war against America by attempting to destroy these three foundation blocks of our republic than any other administration in our history. When I speak to you about protecting our borders, language, and culture, I speak to you as a first-generation American. I am an immigrant son. My ancestors didn't come over on the Mayflower. They came over from Russia in third-class steerage. They worked hard and died young. They learned to speak English and they learned America's ways. They got it on the back of the bus. They didn't demand that they take over the bus and drive it into a wall. They were true American immigrants. But the immigrants of the past are not the same as the immigrants today. I understand that the situation is different now than it was nearly 100 years ago, but the fundamentals of immigration are the same. You come as a guest and then muster up every ounce of compliance and determination you can until you earn your full-time status. This is not the immigration formula under the current administration. Their idea of immigration is to grant amnesty to those who have crossed our borders illegally. I, Michael Savage, oppose amnesty for many reasons, and I will read them to you. I will read them to you. The phone number is 855-407-282. For those of you who purchased Stop the Coming Civil War, get out your book, and you could follow the reading along with me on page 29. And you will see that the war on our borders, language, and culture has now come to face all of us. And when I come back, I will also play sound bites of those who gave us the sanctuary city, including Gavin Newsom boasting about his sanctuary city. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
My Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com. It's the only company I trust to protect my wealth. Call 800-BUY-COIN. So I live in a sanctuary city, and I got to tell you, it's not a pleasant experience. There are gunshots every night in San Francisco's North Beach. Ask people who live there. Gunfights mainly by illegal aliens. In fact, just the other night, seven shots were fired not too far from the Trieste Cafe in North Beach when an illegal alien tried to shoot his wife or girlfriend or whatever she was. But that didn't make it to the newspaper. So who did this to us? Well, there's a lot of names. Gavin Newsom, Kamala Harris. We have a district attorney who did it. Now we learn that Francisco Sanchez, whatever his name is, was deported five times, had seven felony convictions. And the current DA, Mirakrami, whatever his name is, a guy who was once indicted for beating up his wife, and then he rigged the system, in my opinion. Now he's, believe it or not, sheriff again. Here's a guy who was involved in domestic abuse and wound up sheriff in San Francisco. It doesn't get any better. He's proud of the fact that he releases illegal aliens on the sanctuary policy. And they don't even apologize for what happened. I've been doing this for 21 years. Do you think anything is going to change? Do you think that the illiberal bastards who are in power because of the millions of illegal aliens that they have cultivated as voters because the taxpayers hate their guts? You think the taxpayers don't know about the corruption? So the taxpayers hate the politicians. So what did the politicians do, the evil, corrupt politicians? They import millions of illegal aliens who vote for them because the unions show them how to vote. Then they bastardize the voting process and say it's racist to require the language English in order to vote. And they make the ballot in six or seven languages in San Francisco to make sure the corruption can roll on and the potholes not be filled. So let's play for you. Very nice man. I consider him a very nice man. I ran into him in a restaurant not too long ago. I like the guy. But he owns this one. Here is none other than former Mayor Gavin Newsom on his boasting about the sanctuary city. Listen.
We're going to spend resources and time and energy and to do PSAs, to do campaign outreach into community clinics, into our public schools, into our police stations, to let people know what a sanctuary city is all about. We will stand up and fight for people so that they live their lives out loud in the light of day with dignity and respect.
Well, Mr. Sanchez Ramirez lived his life out loud, Mr. Newsom. In fact, he lived his life out loud with three shots. Everyone can hear him. He claims that the sleeping pills did it. Then he says he found the gun under the bench. Then he said he was shooting sea lions, which unto itself is a federal offense and a state offense. Not one word from the liars at PETA about an illegal alien shooting at sea lions. Is that a cultural defense? That in Mexico they're allowed to shoot sea lions? I don't really know. I'll have to look into that. So he's shooting at sea lions and he accidentally shoots this young lady in front of her father. And as she's dying in her father's arms, she says, "Daddy, Daddy, help me. Daddy, help me. It cut me to the core. Could be you. It's two blocks from where I live in San Francisco. I walk there on a regular basis. In fact, I went there yesterday to look at the place. And not too far away, there was a group of people giving out flyers on dogs in cages being held upside down by their feet with their throats being cut for the South Korean dog meat trade. Torturing dogs, killing dogs, eating dogs, the meat market in South Korea. They're doing a good job. But there was nobody, surprisingly, talking about the illegal aliens with guns and knives in San Francisco. The liberals are worried about dogs. I don't blame them. I love dogs. Look what they do to dogs. Men hoist a dog up to hang by the neck in South Korea. And while the dogs are hanging by their neck, the dogs are beaten with metal pipes or burned alive by the South Koreans. You see, the meat is tastier that way. Apparently, the adrenaline and the fear makes the Koreans salivate. Real good. Goes good with kimchi and a cold beer, you know? That's a cultural thing. But there was no one marching about the death of this young lady by the illegal alien.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
You know, you have to take chances in this world. The true demagogues are Barack Obama, the Attorney General, the head of ICE, the mayor of San Francisco in this case, the sheriff of San Francisco, the ex-mayor of San Francisco, and all the others, Kamala Harris, who played a role in making this city safe for illegal aliens. They did so for political reasons, in order to maintain power in their office, maintain their office, and maintain power, because they know that the average citizen who works and lives in San Francisco is on to their corruption and their incompetence and wouldn't vote for them. So they imported an entire population of illegals to keep them in power, is my estimation. So who do you blame? Can you blame all the people of Mexico? That would be crazy. That'd be like saying all Americans are fat and take pills the way Al Jazeera did. You can't do that. It's not correct. So we have to stay focused on who did this to us and try our best to unravel the sanctuary city policy, not only in San Francisco. I have a list of all the major cities that are sanctuary cities, because most of these, like Detroit, are obviously sanctuary cities because they need them as voters. You understand that? How do you think a communist like de Blasio in New York seized power? Through the illegal alien vote, through the unions. That's how. So the fact of the matter is, all we can do is point it out and talk about it. But I have been on the front lines of this battle for 21 years since I entered radio. In fact, as I said to you a number of years ago when I spoke out about the Ramos murders of the Bologna family and then spoke out against the Dreamers, they boycotted my local station. A mob came, a union-controlled mob, and they had T-shirts on condemning Michael Savage. You don't know about this. I didn't make a big issue of it. But they tried to drive me out of the city. Here I am, a distinguished member of the city, being attacked by hordes, armies of illegal aliens who have been encouraged by the corrupt politicians. That's the world. I have pictures, by the way, of those, if you want to see them. My attorney just sent them to me, Dan Horowitz. the greatest attorney in the world. In the world of bad attorneys, Dan Horowitz is the greatest. But I don't want to lose the whole picture here. Again, we're not saying all Mexicans. That would be crazy. You know, let's not generalize. Let's be very specific. And let's talk about this guy Sanchez and who released him. It would be Sheriff Murakami, whatever his name is, in San Francisco, who should be held accountable, number one. He had the power to detain him and notify ICE. The ICE is, of course, the federal agency who would have probably done nothing anyway. Right now, and ICE is pointing their finger at San Francisco. I love that. The very same ICE that doesn't let the Border Patrol do its job and attacks Border Patrol agents who does their job, and now suddenly they're Mr. Supporter of the border. Yeah, I love it. And by the way, where's the president? Duck and cover. He's here hiding. He's hiding now. No one can find the president now after this happened. We have the sound of the shooter. I want to go back to that for a minute because it's a very important story of who he is, where did he get the gun, and why did he kill this woman? I don't believe the story that he found the gun under the bench. Let's say you're a homicide detective. Don't you watch shows on television? I mean, sure, all of you intelligent liberals love television produced by Katzenberg, Hatzenberg, Matzenberg, and Ratzenberg. Don't you watch crime shows such as True Detective, where there's a corrupt politician who's involved with gangs? You didn't see that one last night, huh? You mean that doesn't happen in real life? No, the writers pulled it out of their magic mushrooms. No, the politicians are involved with the gangs. And so the murder stories themselves are written very well, whether it's True Detective or Ray Donovan. Make believe you good liberals who love the media, as I do, were reading this as a television script. And an illegal alien says, oh, I fell asleep, I was on pills, I found the gun, I was shooting sea lions. I mean, would that pass the first grade? Let's listen to the liar, Mr. Whatever his name is. Listen, play it now.
I say I'm sorry, everybody. So I know more play, no more like this, like that and that later.
You won't play with a gun play? Again? Is that what you said?
Oh, yeah. No, me no use gun again. No, me never.
So you feel sorry to? You feel sorry for everyone that's been impacted.
Oh, shut up, you reporter! You useless garbage! You. Here's the reporter coaching him to say he's sorry.
Have you ever fired a gun? Have you ever shot?
No, me never fire a gun. No, no, me never see gun before.
No,
no, no, no, okay. No, me never see.
Do you have a lawyer? Do you have an attorney?
No.
No. No. No, 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 no. Just an interpreter and a news reporter as my attorney. No, just a stooge from KGO Television who's feeding him lines, that's all. What does he need a lawyer for when he's got a liar? What does he need a lawyer for when he has a liar from KGO TV feeding him lines? Oh, well, you feel sorry? Then the interpreter says, yeah, I feel sorry. Where'd you get the gun? Yeah, right, I got the gun, yeah. That's not the story. That's the cover story. That's the cover story. Look, if I were a homicide detective, I don't know, there must be a few left in San Francisco who know what's going on. They've been muzzled, of course, under this regime in this city, which is, I can't imagine being a cop in this city. Couldn't be a harder job in the universe. Imagine a homicide cop in San Francisco, which I think has one of the highest rates of unsolved homicides in the country. But nevertheless, put that aside. What would a homicide detective who's naturally skeptical think about this story? It's just a bunch of crap. What line would you follow if you were a homicide detective? He was a gang member. I'd follow that line and say he is. I would say if I were a homicide detective, I would investigate. Was he a known gang member? Was he told to go and kill a white woman on the pier in order to earn his bones, in order to be made a member? It has happened before. Don't think this is an invented statement. Everybody knows this has happened in this country. The illegals are running wild in the streets of many cities of this country. And by the way, he was once a resident of Texas. I wonder why he chose to jump the border and come back to San Francisco, because he couldn't be deported. And here's another question. Since I thought that federal law controlled immigration, follow my logic if you can, all of you liberals. I thought that local jurisdictions could not enact immigration laws. Didn't Arizona get overturned by the feds, the corrupt Supreme Court, which said it must be followed by the federal law controls immigration? So there's no control of immigration by states or by counties? Then why is San Francisco enacting its own immigration law? Why don't they arrest the people who put this in power? Why don't they immediately detain and arrest the sheriff of San Francisco for violating federal law? I mean, there are laws on the books, and if immigration is controlled by federal law and they're violating federal law, then all city officials who are violating federal law are committing a crime. Doesn't that make sense to you? And let me take it a step further. If San Francisco believes it can create immigration law on its own, then why can't a conservative jurisdiction, whether in California or elsewhere, enact its own immigration law and say we will deport illegal aliens who commit crimes ourselves. We will buy buses and we'll drive them over the border and we'll dump them on the other side of the border because the feds won't do their job. Why can't local jurisdictions do what San Francisco did? And instead of making their cities or towns sanctuary cities, make them deportation cities. If you're committing a crime and you're not a citizen, we will drive you over the border and leave you in the desert because we cannot tolerate crime in our community. And that's what has to happen in this country to teach these liberals a lesson. They've overrun the whole country. They own the media. They own every avenue of discussion, with the rare exception. And so look what has happened now. And I want to talk about that. You believe he found the gun under the bench? You believe he was shooting at sea lions? Where is PETA on this, by the way? He was shooting at sea lions? Huh? He was shooting at sea lions. Why doesn't Sheriff Mirkami, whatever his name, I can't pronounce his name. It's a very complicated name. I know he was arrested a few years ago and indicted and then released for some domestic violence, which was swept under the rug because apparently in San Francisco, the only crimes you can commit are homophobia and anti-immigration rhetoric. But my friends, this is a very serious, serious problem. This is not the first case. As I said to you before, the case of Edwin Ramos, an illegal alien youth from Salvador, killing Tony Bologna, age 48, and his sons Michael, 20, and Matthew, 16, and 08, touched me very deeply. I raised money for Mrs. Bologna. She had a fund. I sent the money. I never got a thank you note. I'd like to see if the lawyers stole the money. I'd like to know who received that money. But nevertheless, that's not the issue. Sunday, June 2008, Tony Bologna, 48, was driving home with his sons, Michael, 20, and Matthew, 16. They went down the wrong alley at the wrong time, and this subhuman, Edwin Ramos, an illegal alien from El Salvador, who had prior arrests for felonies as a child or youth, but benefited from San Francisco's liberal sanctuary policy, executed the whole family with the exception of the mother. She watched her husband and sons get killed in front of her eyes. Did the person who gave us the sanctuary city lose his job? No, he got bumped up to a state job. Did the then district attorney, Kamala Harris, get fired for that? No, she's now attorney general, waiting in the wings to become senator. Or God knows what's next. They control the system. So my friends, the entire country is in trouble because of this. It's a big deal. The country is now looking at this story. I think even the most ignorant of Americans, the dumbest of the dumb, knows about this murder somehow. I think it leaked out even on ABC, CBS, and NBC. I think even they managed to leak the story into the consciousness of the average American. And here in San Francisco, it's a big story. I know people who are not politically oriented at all, who could care less because they've given up on the system, are shocked by this and they're enraged. They're fuming. They want somebody to go to prison for this. They want the sheriff arrested. They want somebody to pay for this murder because there is blood on the hands of the politicians. Oh, yeah, this guy Ramirez, whatever his name is, did the shooting. Okay, by all reports, he did the shooting with the gun he found while dozing off shooting sea lions. What a story that was. Who gave him that story? I wonder which shyster gave him that story. Where did he get that story from? Let's see. Sleeping pills, gun under the bench, shooting at sea lions, me accidentally shoot girl, me sorry. Where did he get that from? Who gave him that story? He got it awfully fast, didn't he? But nevertheless, the city officials are the ones who enable this. You know, for every cause, there's an effect. And so if you're a lawless politician who will not arrest illegal aliens, even those who commit crimes, and then crimes are committed, you should be held responsible. Mike on KSFO in the city of San Francisco. Welcome, Michael. What's your opinion today?
Hi, Mike. I just want to relate a conversation I had with a San Francisco cop a couple years back. We were looking up at Potrero Hill, commenting on how many gang members live up there. MS-13 owns a bunch of houses up there. And I said, why don't you do something about it? He said, we're outgunned, and there's too much money flowing into City Hall.
Mm.
That's what he said. That's all he had to say.
Too much money flowing into City Hall. Does that explain it? No, the cities today are like Chicago was under Al Capone. The only problem is we do not have a counterpoint to the crime and the criminals in high places. There is no Elliot Ness. Where is the Elliot Ness now that we need him? Where is a federal agent of the type that brought down Al Capone? Do we have any? They've all been nullified by the gangster in the White House. It's as though Al Capone is running America, let alone the Justice Department. Tell me where the FBI is on this. Silent, I suppose. They're looking into returning war veterans, anti-abortion protesters, anyone with blonde hair and blue eyes who wears a cross, who loves America, returned from Afghanistan or Iraq. I guess they're busy doing that over there at the FBI. They're too busy doing that at the FBI, the Federal Bureau of Interrogation. Yep, we have trouble. And here we are talking about it. And what good is it? Tell me what good it is. Randy on WABC, go ahead. You're on the Savage Nation.
Hello, Michael. I've been listening to you since you were on ABC at night. And, you know, most of the time I thought you were you sugar-coated things, that you looked through things with rose-colored glasses and that you were very naive. But when you said today that we need to remove the word stop from the stop the coming civil war, I thought you were yelling fire in a crowded theater. And that's the reason I have...
Then why don't you report me to the Attorney General then?
That's the reason I have hope for you.
No. Why don't you call up the Attorney General or the FBI and report me? After all, I'm a bigger criminal than the murderer, right?
Michael, you're not listening. That's the reason I have hope for you. Because
you have
now
hope
maybe
for me.
You're...
That's very nice of you. In other words, you who wants the Civil War, not me.
No, I don't. No, not Civil War.
Let me tell you something. Obama declared a civil war in America from the day he became president. He's been conducting a civil war against every institution in this country, including flooding America with immigrants who will never, ever assimilate into this nation, never become part of the fabric of the nation, which is his entire goal. So tell me who started the civil war. It's him and his illegal gang of liberal goons. They're conducting a civil war against the middle class. I think that's what you're saying, aren't you?
No. We want a No. We want comprehensive government reform and replacement. Look, if you
That's
like it.
That's right, we do. We want comprehensive government reform and replacement. We don't want immigration reform. We want comprehensive government reform. We'd like to see all of them thrown out of office. But take a look at who's waiting in the wings. Jeb Bush. Jeb Bush attacked Trump, didn't he? Trump is the only one who can save us, incidentally. However, by the time Trump became president, I can guarantee you his position would change. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
The Savage Nation is sponsored by Swiss America, the only company I trust with my financial future. Call 800-289-2646 or SwissAmerica.com. Just blame Republicans for the deported San Francisco killer. You heard me right. Josh Ernst, the Goebbels of this administration, when asked by reporters about critics of Obama's immigration policies, Goebbels Ernst insisted it was Republicans who were at fault for voting against the bill last year, which contained funding to increase border security. Josh Ernst, if there are ever war crimes trials for what was done to America during this regime's reign, you should be number one on the docket. You are the Goebbels of our time for blaming Republicans, because you damn well know it's liberals like you, liberal policies like that of Obama, and liberals like that in San Francisco, such as the mayor, the attorney general of the state of California, Sheriff Mirkami in particular, who are responsible for this tragedy on San Francisco's pier the other day. She died in her father's arms saying, "Daddy, help me."
Warning. The Savage Nation contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised. And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, The Savage Nation, home of unprotected talk, borders, language, culture. And here he is, Michael Savage.
Did you shoot Kate Steinling, the lady who was down on Pier 14?
Yes.
You did shoot her. Mm-hmm. Where did you get the gun?
In the ground, when that's over there in the bench, I put my leg, and I see the one teacher, and I see over there something like that. That's only I hear the boom, boom, 3 times.
Mm-hmm. So he found the gun under the benchy, and it went boom, boom by itself, like a Dybbuk. A devil came out of the air and shot the gun. Then he said he was shooting sea lions. I don't believe any of it. It's rubbish. Somebody fed him the story. Welcome to the Savage Nation. It's a disaster. The sanctuary city of San Francisco is a disaster to begin with. The nation is now staring straight in the eyes of insanity. And remember who wrote the book in 2005 entitled Liberalism is a Mental Disorder? In that book, I had a chapter entitled Alien Invasion. Tell me what's changed in the 10 years. For that matter, tell me what's changed in the last 21 years since I have been on the radio trying to warn America about the flood that has overrun our borders because of corrupt politicians. But it's not just people coming over the border, the flood of human contraband that ranchers have been confronting on our southern border every day in Texas and Arizona is a national scandal. It's insanity. That's what's been going on in the country. And as a result of this country's president, if you want to call him that, the regime has basically melted our border with Mexico, not only allowing a deluge of illegals to flow across the border, but also he has tied the hands of the men and women whose job it is to defend our national security. There are many stories that are connected to this, and it's all related to illegal aliens who are overrunning a nation in an invasion. If you care to comment on any of this, the phone number is 855-487-2822. We have the sound bites. We have the names. We know whose blood is on the hands of the gun. Where did he get the gun? You actually believe that this illegal alien got the gun under the bench? He found it in a rag under the bench? Do you believe he was shooting sea lions and PETA has not screamed about him killing innocent animals in San Francisco Bay? He could have been deported just for that. Sea lions are protected by federal law. I haven't heard any Department of Game come down and say we want to hold him for killing sea lions. No, there's no one who's going to pay for this, as you well know, other than the poor average Joe and Jane in San Francisco, who is so tolerant that they look the other way. It's not that they're liberal or schmibberal. They know the city is corrupt and it runs on its own power. They know the streets are broken. Drive on Lombard Street from the Golden Gate Bridge to Van Ness and tell me if the street looks like the street of a first world city or a fourth world city. San Francisco has worse streets than Malaysia. San Francisco has worse streets than Shanghai. Where does all of the highway funding go? I'll let you figure out where it goes. 855-400-728 to let the people talk, Michael. WABC, Moses, you're on. Go ahead. What's on your mind? Hello, Moses, fire away. Go ahead. Fire away. You're on the radio. Go ahead, Moses.
The president. The president's doing a great job. You know, he's...
All right. You can make blanket statements like that. The president has melted our borders down and turned the other cheek with regard to illegals swarming over the border. What are you talking about?
What do you want them to do? You're such an alarmist. Do you want to build a defensive rampart like the Berlin Wall, which didn't work?
Yes, I want a wall between America and Mexico. What do you want, an illegal shooting you or raping your girlfriend?
Irrespective of whether the immigration status is still a crime. You can't indict a whole group of people because one person commits a crime.
Well, who's inviting a whole group of people? I'm indicting our politicians for not following immigration law. What are you talking about?
That's a different argument. You're saying the entire city of San Francisco is corrupt. It's not true. That's a blanket.
It is corrupt. It's the most corrupt city in America. It's more corrupt than New Orleans. I stand by those words. Take a look at the city. Look at the corruption. Take a look at the streets. Take a look at the bums in the streets. Ask where the billions of dollars are going. What do you mean? That is corruption, is it not?
It's corruption based upon capitalistic principles.
Oh, no, now you're switching it now. Now you want to give me a communist speech. Why don't you get a soapbox and go down to Union Square like your grandfather did when he just got off the boat from Minsk?
Understand, borders, language, and culture. This is the exact argument they use against Jews around the world.
Here we go again. It's always the Jews, isn't it? Are you Jewish, Moses?
Ostensibly. But
what do you mean, ostensibly? Wait a minute. Are you Jewish? I'm asking you. Are you of Jewish heritage?
Yes.
Yes or no? I don't understand. You're not answering a simple question.
I am.
You just brought up Jews. Are you Jewish or not?
Yes.
You are. So why do you take the side of illegal aliens instead of your home country? Tell me where that comes from.
Because as a Jew, we have compassion for people all around.
Why don't you have compassion for the country that saved you from Hitler?
Compassion. But remember,
why don't you have compassion for the soldiers who saved the Jews in the gas chambers?
We didn't fight World War II to liberate any Jews in World War II. That was a byproduct.
Oh, you are really a sick puppy.
I'm not.
You are a true America hater, aren't you?
I'm not an America hater.
You are a disgrace to the Jewish people. Let me tell you something. You didn't do the Jewish people a favor in coming on this show and disgracing yourself like this.
I disgrace myself because I don't go with this nationalist nonsense.
So you hate the nation, in other words. You're an internationalist. Is that what you're saying?
Not that I'm an internationalist. In New York, we're a sanctuary city as well. It's because we want people are going to come here whether we want them or not. We want to help.
What do you mean they're going to come here whether you want them or not? Of course that's nonsense. They're coming there because there's freebies for them. What are you talking about? Where do you think all the welfare goes?
Welfare goes.
By the way, Moses, I know you're a brilliant man, probably as smart as Einstein, but tell me what percent of the population in our prisons consists of illegal aliens who have committed felonies. Do you know the answer?
I couldn't tell you because most statistics are made up on the spot.
Moses, you know, you think you're glib, but you know, you're not in a club on Houston Street right now shooting your mouth off after drinking too much and smoking a joint. The fact is there's a statistic. It's about 33%. One out of three prisoners in our federal jails, federal prisons, are here because they committed a felony other than an immigration crime. Don't tell me they all come here to work and they're all so wonderful. That's nonsense.
They are wonderful. This makes our country great. But they wind
all right,
up in
you, all right, you just want to get me agitated. And that's because your father wasn't strong enough to stand up to you. So you became a loudmouth who just shoots his mouth off to antagonize men who are much smarter than yourself. Is there anything intelligent you'd like to say before I hang up on you?
I want you to have more compassion for the average person.
I don't want to have more compassion for criminals. Why don't you have compassion?
It's not.
Why don't you fly out to San Francisco and hold Mr. Sanchez's hand? Why don't you start a defense fund for Mr. Sanchez and say he was picked on by right-wingers? Why don't you do that, Moses?
I'm not justifying Mr. Sanchez in any extent, but the right-wing aspect.
No, wait a minute. Why don't you fly to San Francisco and why don't you ask to see Mr. Lopez Sanchez and ask if you can start a defense fund for Lopez Sanchez?
The problem that you don't want to talk about, Mr. Lopez Sanchez had access to a firearm because of the Second Amendment, which is so sacred to everybody. Why are there so many guns?
It was the Second Amendment, by the way, that saved your sad behind, isn't it? By the way, Mr. Moses, when you come out of a nightclub at 3 in the morning and your life is in danger from a thug, who would you turn to, the ACLU or a cop with a gun?
Look,
what's the matter now, Moses?
The cops.
What's the matter? The Red Sea didn't part for you because suddenly you can't answer the question? Moses, when did you become gunophobic? What was it in your childhood that scared you from guns? Is it because you're partly suicidal or the medication you're on?
No, there was a lot of killings.
Is it the medication in your psyche that has you fear guns? What do you fear about guns?
Because people get their hands on them, they commit murders like this.
Really? And they don't save lives with guns, Moses?
Don't. The idea that people wouldn't have died at Columbine.
You know, I've had enough of you. Take a walk. Go get a corned beef at Katz's. Do me a favor. Or a tofu sandwich at Katz's. Never call the show again. You just lowered the IQ of the entire show. You know, when guys like him call, he's just having fun. His friends are probably sitting around. Let me call that right winger and have him there. You know what? You got nowhere, Moses. All you did was embarrass the Jewish people. You made people think very, very poorly of the Jewish people, Moses. That's all you achieved. This is the Savage Nation. We are talking about an illegal alien from Mexico who executed a 32-year-old girl in front of her father. And as she lay dying, she said, "Daddy, Daddy, save me." That's what just happened two blocks from my apartment. That is what we are talking about. and the creep, homicidal maniac or gang member, whatever he may actually be, who did it, Lopez or whatever his name is. He has several aliases, don't you know? Lopez or Sanchez. Lopez says he found the gun under the bench, and of course an idiot like Moses believes that. I don't. How come Moses didn't talk about Lopez Sanchez taking the gun he found under the bench and shooting sea lions, which I don't believe either? I'd like to know why Moses didn't suggest that Lopez Sanchez, as an upstanding citizen of Mexico, didn't call the nearest cop and say, excuse me, but I found the gun under the bench. Why didn't he do that? Why did he pick it up and start shooting it, boom, 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 at sea lions, Moses? See if you can part the Red Sea of truth, Moses, and maybe when you cleanse the doors of perception, you will see life as it is, infinite. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
Hey, our Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com, the only company I trust for wealth insurance, gold and silver. Call 800-BUY-COIN. You know, not long ago.
Mr. Sanchez, tell me why you're here, and just you can look at me.
Okay. Yes, because that when the cash the police in my arrest, the I got now the information and the
yeah, I know why he's here. Right, free welfare. That's all. He came here to work. Yeah, they all come here to work. They're all better than any American. Ask Obama. Nancy Pelosi ought to go wash the blood off his hands. After all, she washed the feet of the children last summer that Obama flooded America with. Do you remember that? How many of those children brought diseases, Moses? You wouldn't know that in the pot haze in which you live, Moses. But I know the statistics, Moses, because I have a PhD in epidemiology, Moses, from a great university, Moses. Many of those children brought in viruses from their country, Moses, and infected children in America, Moses. Some children are in a state of paralysis ever since that previously unseen virus was brought here, Moses. But it didn't make it to your sanctuary city, did it, Moses? You were busy supporting the illegal aliens. You were busy hating the Second Amendment. You were busy hating nationalism. You were busy hating America. By the way, Moses, another factor for you. You say that you're Jewish. Well, let me tell you something. Where did you get the idea that a Jew is supposed to be compassionate above all other people? Where did you get that twisted idea that the religion of Judaism is about compassion and not about the worship of God, Moses? I'll tell you where you got it from. You got it from your foolish liberal parents who raised you not in Judaism, but in liberalism under the guise of Judaism. You represent one of millions of liberal Jews in America who have twisted the whole meaning of the religion itself into thinking you're supposed to be compassionate. Well, fine if you're compassionate, but that's not the core of your religion. In fact, if you read the Old Testament, it's the opposite of compassion. It's all about a very angry God for a very wayward people, Moses. Read the Old Testament sometime when you have a little time. And speaking about that, let's talk about our Muslim friends for a moment. Let's talk about ISIS. Let's talk about Islam, which has been at war with the world for 1,000 years. And let's talk about the phonies who I described to you as phonies last Thursday on this program, who warned you of an imminent attack coming July 4th. Dianne Feinstein, that old harridan, oh, attack coming. Oh, there's a lot of chatter. DHS, oh, an attack is highly likely July 4th. Let's see. Every agency of Obama's regime was warning you not to enjoy July 4th. They were telling you to fear an attack. Well, July 4th came and went, and there was no attack. Who told you it was like firemen starting fires in order to justify their ballooning budgets? Me. Who told you there would be no attack? Me. Who told you that these agencies are bloated with trillions of dollars in spending and they have nothing to do? So they make up fear tactics that there was an attack coming. Let me tell you something. There may be an attack coming, but it didn't come on July 4th. And let me tell you something else. In my novel, Countdown to Mecca, you will see what's liable to happen in this world unless this government does its job. You're liable to see a group of rogue generals, if there are any left, plotting something to save America because the government won't do it itself. Incidentally, you can read all about it in the novel, Countdown to Mecca, available right now. It's a very important novel, or I wouldn't tell you about it. Believe me, I don't need the money. Right now, I've given the money away, especially in my scholarship fund. The five $20,000 winners are on michaelsavage.com. If you want to read the essays, you should do so. It's right in the middle of the website. Here are the winning essays in the Savage Scholarship Contest. Five young college students won the award. 1,700 people applied. Five were chosen, and they're stirring essays, and they're very encouraging about the future of America, because not everybody is as brainwashed as Moses. Some of them actually love America. Some of them know that the Second Amendment was created to protect the citizen from an overbearing government, unlike Moses. But nevertheless, here's something interesting as a side note. That article, the winning essays, the Savage Scholarship Contest, where $100,000 will be given away, five winners, was not covered by anyone in the major conservative media. Drudge wouldn't link it. Only a few websites covered the story. I wonder why they only report bad news. And it made me think about the entire conservative movement, how I spent months trying to create something positive, and Breitbart wouldn't link it. Drudge wouldn't link it. None of the big sites that we all go to would talk about the winning essays and have you read anything positive. And then a bell went off in my head. And I realized that the so-called conservative media is identical to the liberal media. They're just the other side of the coin. They're all scandal mongers. They're in business only to freak you out and scare you. When anything positive comes along, they won't report on it. They want to keep you agitated and frightened, and I want nothing more to do with it. I am sick of it. I'm not going to engage in the scandal mongering in order to survive in the radio business or as an author. So the fact is that today's show is not about scandal mongering. Today's show is not about muckraking. Today's show is about warning America about the illegal aliens amongst us and the crimes that are being committed in their names by them, and the cover-up by the liberal media and by the corrupt politicians who refuse to identify them or deport them. They won't even permit calling them illegal aliens. They're undocumented citizens. My behind, they're undocumented citizens.
Why do they have sanctuary cities? In large measure because if local law enforcement begins to act like immigration enforcement officers, what that means is that you will have people not reporting crimes, you will have people hiding from the police, and I think that is a real direct threat to the personal safety and security of all the citizens. So this is a result of the failure of the federal government, and that's where it needs to be fixed.
So here's Hillary Clinton a few years ago in 07. Saying sanctuary cities keep all citizens safe. This soundbite was found by Breitbart, and we ran it for you on the Savage Nation. And she was, again, using doublespeak of the type we were warned about by George Orwell in saying that not only will sanctuary cities keep all citizens safe, but we can't have local law enforcement acting like immigration officers. Well, how do you explain the sheriff of San Francisco, Mirakami, acting like an immigration officer and not deporting Sanchez, and then went and shot this woman? And by the way, the questions surrounding the murder are the ones that I would like answered. A, is he a known gang member? B, where did he get the gun? C, what was the caliber of the gun? D, was it a gang initiation, of which there have been many in San Francisco and other cities in America, incidentally? Don't put your rose-colored glasses on. We all know this is going on. The country is being overrun by lawlessness, and we have to stand up to it. They are dumping not only the hardworking poor of Mexico and the other Central American nations upon us. They are doing what Cuba did with the Mariel boat invasion. They're dumping their criminals on us as well. See, this is the subtlety of Trump's argument. Trump's argument was true up to a point. The illegitimate left is saying that he said all Mexicans are criminals. That's not what he said at all. But the truth is that like the Mariel boat invasion of America by Fidel Castro, our new friend, or the new friend of this regime in the White House, you remember the Mariel boat invasion of Miami back in the 80s when he emptied his prisons of murderers and rapists and such and let them flood into Miami? Do you remember what happened in Miami at that time? Make no mistake about it. in addition to the large percentage of poor who come across the border to reap the benefits of the fat of the land, in other words, the milk and honey that we worked for, to take it for themselves, to drink our milk and to enjoy our honey, and send all of the proceeds to the home country, paying zero taxes. In addition to those hardworking folks who we see everywhere, make no mistake about it, there is a percentage of criminals that are being sent across the border by the Mexican elite because they don't want to deal with them themselves. They will not admit that many of the hardworking migrants are surrounded by many criminals who go back and forth across the border. That's the truth. It's the sad truth, and it has to be faced. And I do want a wall. In fact, you say, do you want, that caller said to me, do you want a wall? I'm sorry to tell you that Trump got it from my book. In one of my previous books, one of my points was build a wall with Mexico. And I even went further than Trump. I know he got that from my book. One of his speechwriters must have read it. And I said, build a wall with Mexico. It's a no-brainer. And by the way, Moses, if you're still listening, didn't Israel build a wall between Israel and the West Bank to stop Palestinians from murdering their men, women, and children with cafe bombs? Remember that, Moses? And it was liberals like you in Israel and elsewhere who said, hey, that's so inhumane, that's so non-Jewish to build a wall. Welcome the Palestinians in. And if a few of us have to die from the bombs, hey, what's the difference? You know, we're humane people. We can't wall the Palestinians out. Well, Moses, my dear boy, after the Israelis finished that wall with the West Bank, the number of suicide bombings went down to near zero, Moses. When is the last time you read of a suicide bombing in Israel, Moses? Not for a long time, Moses. You know why? Because Jews, not like you, built the wall and guard the wall. They're busy defending themselves instead of defending the criminals, Moses. And so that's why I say, not only should we build a wall between the United States and Mexico, which is long overdue, but we should hire illegal aliens to build the wall and pay them for their work and then repatriate them back to their home country after the wall is built. That's not a bad idea. And Donald Trump probably has an architect and contractors who could oversee the construction of the wall. After all, Moses, didn't the Chinese build the Great Wall of China, a famous tourist attraction? Do you know why the Chinese built that Great Wall of China, Moses? Because they were being overrun by illegal aliens who were raping, murdering, and plundering China itself. Did you know that, Moses? I guess you didn't read that in your elementary school when you were studying humanism instead of Judaism. And now it's time for another soundbite from Al Gore's prior network, the Al Jazeera network. Remember when Al Gore bought that? Boy, is this guy smart. He comes up with the global warming scam, makes billions. He's the son of a man who made money, fortune in coal. He's making money in the green racket. Doesn't get any better. He sells his network to Al Jazeera, who's dying to have a propaganda outlet in America. It's dying in front of our eyes. And yet over the weekend, even Al Jazeera went to a new low. They did a July 4th video where they attack America and Americans. I'm sure Moses and his liberal friends will giggle over this in clip 3. Listen.
You probably know that the U.S. leads the world in the most Olympic medals won, the most number of Nobel laureates, and the most billionaires.
But we also lead the world in some other ways.
Not to brag, but we have the most incarcerated people in the world. God bless the prison industrial complex.
When it comes to obesity, we lead the global Mickey D's line. A third of us can't even see our own toes.
Leading nation in cheese production? America. Specifically, probably Wisconsin.
Pew, pew. We've got 90 guns for 100 persons. Sorry, Yemen. We beat you in drones and guns.
We make 89% of the world's porn. That makes porn as American as church on Sunday.
Americans consume 80% of the world's painkillers. Makes sense, though, right? I mean, racism in this country is a big pain in the ass.
Other developed nations can't compete when we lead with the most number of teen pregnancies per capita. What?
Credit card debt? Grab your Visa, because we lead the world in that, too.
Just think of all the air miles.
So, if anyone ever tells you America's not that great, just say, God bless the country with the most deaths by lawnmower.
All right, you get the picture. I wonder when Al Jazeera is going to focus on the number of child rapes and kidnappings by ISIS. I wonder when these snotty vermin at Al Jazeera are going to produce a tape about the wonderful life for women and girls, and for that matter, in any Arab country on earth. And I wonder when Al Jazeera is going to produce a snotty little tape like this one, this anti-American tape, about life for the average woman or girl in any Muslim country, especially an African Muslim country. The day Al Jazeera does that is the day that Al Gore ought to buy it back for pennies on the dollar. I'm Michael Savage. Now let's go to the callers. Let's go to Renee on KSFO in San Francisco. Renee, what's on your mind?
Hey, Michael. I just wanted to relate my point. I was a victim of a heinous rape and beating 20 years ago who was committed by an illegal alien and is still today in this country. I tracked him on Megan's Law on the website. He's about an hour away from where I live. And is still to this day committed acts of rape, burglary.
You mean, wait a minute, you're saying that he has not yet been hired by Sheriff Mirkami in San Francisco to be an assistant deputy sheriff?
Yeah, very surprising indeed.
Well, you mean Governor Brown hasn't made him the head of La Raza, the La Raza office in Sacramento?
Yeah, I'm surprised he's not working under the, what's the guy's name who heads it up, of the La Raza.
Yeah, and by the way, maybe he was a dreamer himself. He dreamed of raping someone, and he got away with it. I mean, that's a great dream, isn't it?
No, absolutely. Absolutely.
All right, so you're saying he raped you, and what happened? Why wasn't he arrested?
He was arrested. This happened when I was 13 years old. I had to go to court and testify against him while he sat in court. I was not comfortable testifying. I was in foster care at the time, and I told my social worker and that I didn't want to sit up there and have him look at me and have to look at him while I testified. I just felt sick and disgusted. I felt like I was...
So you're saying you did not testify because of the pain it would have caused you and humiliation, right?
Well, all they had me do was point out who did it to me, and I sat there and pointed at him. I said, that's the man who raped me, and they...
Right, but was he convicted of the crime, Renee?
Yeah, he was.
And how many years did he serve?
He only served 5 years.
Well, I guess your life isn't worth very much. After all, it's only a rape. Well, it's not a big deal to liberals.
The
rape is nothing to them since they engage in that behavior for free. So what's the difference to them?
Right, exactly. So, yeah, and to Moses, you know, the idiot who called earlier... it's just really offended by his remarks. He's just an idiot.
Well, he was just trying to get the goat of all patriots and nationalists in America. He was a classic Estes Sturber. I know the type. So do you know which other cities are sanctuary cities? Because I have the list. I put it up on michaelsavage.com. You'd be shocked to find out that San Francisco is not the only sanctuary city. But there are many, many others, and we have the complete list for those who really want to look at this. But never forget the names, Renee, of the people who gave this to us. It was Mayor Gavin Newsom, who is now Lieutenant Governor, who announced the city would not cooperate with federal immigration raids in keeping with the sanctuary city policy adopted in 1989. Did you know that?
I did. It's unbelievable.
Did you remember the murder of the Bologna family by the illegal alien Edwin Ramos in 2008?
I do remember that, yes.
Yes, it broke my heart. Could you imagine being the mother and wife of that family, the Bologna family, sitting in a car as an illegal from El Salvador? You go down a wrong lane by accident in San Francisco, and this piece of garbage, Edwin Ramos, an illegal alien, with a previous history of violence, by the way, shoots and kills the father and two sons in front of the mother. And guess what happened? Instead of Kamala Harris, the then, I think, district attorney, being fired, she is promoted now to being attorney general of the state of California. Can you believe that?
She should be jailed. She should be jailed.
How do you feel about Sheriff Mirkami, who released this guy who killed this woman the other day? What do you think the crime should be for him? Didn't he not break the law by not detaining the man?
Yes. No, not only that, well, he shouldn't have ever been elected sheriff in the first place. He never served as a sheriff in any county in the Bay Area, let alone...
Isn't this the same man who was arrested and indicted for beating his wife, and then the case was dismissed because of some kind of legal shenanigans? Isn't that true?
That's right.
Yeah. Have you ever heard of a city in the world that would hire someone with a case against a woman like that as sheriff? I don't understand that unless you say it's a corrupt city. And so for Moses to say it's not a corrupt city is astonishing. Look, it's a terrible thing that's going on, Renee. We're not overly smearing an entire race with this crime, but we are using this crime to try to exemplify the dangers that we are all in and have been ever since these Fabian socialist liberals invented the concept of a sanctuary city. Renee, I'm sending you a copy of Countdown to Mecca, my latest novel. And the reason I'm doing so is because I'm trying to warn you about the threat, the very real threat, from Iran and the friends of Barack Obama. Thank you. Stay on the line. Lorraine on KSFO in San Francisco, what's on your mind?
I get so angry, I can spit. I'm so sick of this crap and the bleeding heart liberals and all this garbage. I'm a black Christian. And, you know, when I hear all this old crap about black people don't do this, we're more conservative than people really know. We don't put up with that crap. I don't like it. We just had a conversation about it on Friday. Trump said the truth about a lot of it. There's a lot of gangs. All them people don't come here to work. Why should they take my job or somebody else's job? I work hard for my money, and then I got to pay for you to get free welfare and free food. I can't get it. I got to work for mine. What's the deal? I just don't understand. You just don't.
Well, you're making an important point because conservative Christian blacks like yourself are not heard from by the American media. They will not interview you because you're not a useful idiot. The only black people who the media will go to are those who are discontent with the nation. And discontent with Christianity itself. And I know it very well, that the African Christian community, if you want to call it that, or the African American Christian community is the bedrock of the African American community. It's certainly not those with the pants hanging under their behinds, is it? They're the only ones you ever see in the media. The ones with the gold in the teeth with the pants under their behind. They're now representative of an entire race of people? Tell me that's not racist. And so why do we have to look at them day and night instead of churchgoers like yourself?
And it makes me angry because they ask me, how do I feel about gays? When I tell them, they don't put mine on the TV. You know, it's when it started with the medical insurance for them. Why should I pay for somebody to get a...
You know, that's an interesting subject that didn't come up when the Supreme Court violated the Constitution and upheld gay marriage. Let me tell you something. I remember when it was voted on in California, the proposition that would have banned gay marriages or whatever, same-sex marriage, however you call it. Do you know that it was 90% of the African-American population, which is extremely liberal, voted against gay marriage? Did you know that?
Yeah, you know, I know that because I was...
90% of African-Americans in California said no to gay marriage. 85% of Chinese Americans, or 90%, said no to gay marriage. 60% of Hispanics said no to gay marriage. And that was left out of the discussion when that law was overridden. The state law on that was overridden by a few jackals in black robes. I'll be right back. Stay in the line, Lorraine. I'm sending you my novel, Countdown to Mecca. Be here or be nowhere.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
Your Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com. It's the only company I trust for tangible assets, gold and silver. Call 800-BUICOIN. In the next hour, we're going to play astonishing footage of Perry, Pataki, Perry, Bush, Romney, and of course, the sauerkraut hammer attacking Donald Trump. What I find most amusing about the statements is when guys like Perry and Bush and Romney say, Donald Trump doesn't represent the Republican Party. Duh. Of course he doesn't. The Republican Party lied to the voters. You told us that when you were elected, you would reverse Obama's criminal acts against the American people, including closing the border with Mexico, and you stabbed us in the back. So thank God for Trump. And, of course, you'd expect that from Krauthammer, one of the biggest phony liberals in history, who can only work at Fox News, where they would pose him as somebody who's fair and balanced. Of course he would join the parade because he's a jealous little man. They're nothing but toad dust compared to Trump. Put that in your pipe, Krauthammer, and smoke it.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage. Warning, the Savage Nation contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised. And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, The Savage Nation, home of unprotected talk, borders, language, culture. And here he is, Michael Savage.
Blue Monday, how are you, Blue Monday? Got to work, like a slave all day. Here come Tuesday.
Yes, indeed. Mexico is on everyone's mind. To the liberals, it's the fault of the Second Amendment that a gun was found under a bench. To the animal rights fanatics at PETA, although the illegal from Mexico who shot this poor woman in front of her father's eyes said he was shooting at sea lions, there is no crime by an illegal alien when it comes to animals because it's a cultural thing. Apparently, you can even shoot sea lions if you're an illegal alien in San Francisco as long as you're not a native citizen. And of course, to the establishment in San Francisco, it's just another day in the life of a corrupt liberal regime saying, you know what, it'll blow over. Don't worry about it. We got over the last one. Just don't talk about it. Just let it go by. Don't even talk about it. Remember when they shot the Bologna family? It was a bad scene for a while, but what the heck? Kamala Harris is now attorney general of the state. Didn't hurt her. Gavin Newsom is now lieutenant governor. Didn't hurt him. And so just let it blow over. Don't say nothing. They'll forget it. The jerks who pay the taxes will go on. Nothing will happen. That's topic one. Topic two is Greece. I didn't touch on Greece in 2 hours, but I'll touch on it now and I'll give you a short capsule because I read the financial papers on this morning. One of the reasons that the stock market rebounded here in the U.S. after initially taking a tumble is because investors realized that global markets are not really going to be affected by the Greek crisis. Why? Well, it's simple, because Greece is a very small part of the Eurozone economy. Greece accounts for just 0.33% of global GDP. Did you know that? They produce Gornish, nothing, Balt, nothing. Greece produces, what do they produce in Greece? Ouzo, and who drinks Ouzo? I'm sorry to tell you, I admire the Greek people, at least in Aristotle's time. I admire the Greek people in Plato's time, but they don't produce anything, because they account for less than 1% of the global stock market value, and they only produce 0.33% of global GDP. They're living on German and French workers' behinds, and so many of them are on false disability. 800 of them on one little island claim they're blind so they can collect full disability. Like here in San Francisco, go around the cafes in North Beach and try to find out how many of the bums sitting around who never worked a day in their life are collecting crazy checks. You'll be quite surprised to find that many wine glasses and coffee cups are consumed by those on crazy checks in San Francisco who never worked a day in their life. You know what a crazy check is, don't you? It's not just Social Security, it's Social Security disability. The last I checked, there were over 14 million Americans collecting federal disability pay thanks to Obama's loosening of the laws. So if you think that we're much different than Greece, well, I got another guest coming for you. We're Greece on steroids. It's only a matter of time until the world catches up with the fact that this is also a welfare state that's a basket case. That's topic two. Topic three that I have to introduce. As you know, the show is a three-hour show. As you have probably heard, those of you who listen in the third hour, there are some stations which mistakenly carry only 2 hours of the show, for whatever the reasons are. Well, today I'm happy to announce that one of my giant affiliates, WBAP in Dallas, has decided to take the full 3 hours of the Savage Nation to enjoy what you, the listeners, have long enjoyed, which is the wit and wisdom of Michael Savage. So thank you, program manager in Dallas, and I would hope that you will tell your cousins in some of the other cities what they're missing. If they only look at the ratings, they'll see what happens. Their ratings kind of go down in the third hour when they drop me. Nevertheless, thank you, BAP, and I'm glad to be with you on the Savage Nation. Of course, the big topic is the illegal invasion, the illegal alien invasion in particular, and the killing of this poor young woman. And if it were the first time this happened, we wouldn't be talking about it. Unfortunately, there's a long list of serious crimes by illegal aliens, which I have put on michaelsavage.com, posted courtesy of fairus.org. The information will show you the aliens were all in this country illegally. Many of them had come into the hands of law enforcement agencies prior to the crimes described, but the illegal was not deported, or in some cases was deported but walked back across the turnstile of the Mexican border. And these cases are worth reading. July 2015, Eva Olivos Gutierrez. June 2015, a Salvadoran Mauricio Hernandez, rapist, murderer. May 15, a Salvadoran Julio C. Saravilla. May 2015, two Mexicans, Juan Hernandez Sanchez and Canela Perez. May 2015, Zhang Yang Chen and Dong Bang Lin from China were convicted of first-degree murder and sentenced to life in prison in New Jersey, here illegally. May 2015, Bernabe Flores. Well, you get the picture. Now, without overplaying this particular tragedy, as did Pataki. I don't know. Why is anyone listening to Pataki, what he has to say about Trump? Pataki was a nonentity as a governor. He has about as much chance to be the president as my dog does. In fact, I would think Teddy would pull a higher number than Pataki. But they all jumped on Donald Trump. And what's amusing about it is that here's Romney and Bush and Perry saying that Trump does not represent Republican values. Of course he doesn't. He represents American values. The Republicans represent a corrupt party. That's all they represent. What are Republican values? None. What does Jeb Bush stand for? Nothing but stuffing his own pockets. Jeb Bush is, of course, a perfect Republican. He is the epitome of everything wrong with America. A phony will tell you that he'll do something different than Obama when he's Obama in another set of clothes. So I want you to listen to this horrendous montage of these turncoat liars in the Republican Party attacking the one candidate who could actually win, who represents America, and joining the chorus is none other than Krauthammer, Sauer Krauthammer, who has nothing good to say about anybody, a sourpuss, a liberal through and through, somebody that only Fox News could present as fair and balanced. Listen to clip number one.
The fact is, I've said very clearly that Donald Trump does not represent the Republican Party. I was offended by his remarks.
I'm calling on every other Republican candidate to stand up and say that what Donald Trump said is wrong and they should repudiate it just the way I am now.
To paint with that broad a brush that Donald Trump did is, I mean, he's going to have to defend those remarks. I never will, and I will stand up and say that those are offensive. Which
he thinks that every Mexican crossing the border is a rapist. I mean, so he's doing this to inflame and to incite and to get to draw attention, which is seems to be his organizing principle of his campaign. And he doesn't represent the Republican Party or its values.
He made a severe error in saying what he did about Mexican Americans.
Next up is the Kraut.
Well, I don't think he's reflecting the Republican Party with his statements about Mexicans. I think that was a huge error on his part. And number one, it's wrong.
Jeb Bush and Marco Rubio and the others have not needed Trump to raise the issue of immigration, particularly in this way, is definitely hurting the brand and distracting the entire
brand.
I
salute
Donald Trump for focusing on
good
the
for
need
Ted Cruz
to address illegal
good
immigration. I salute Donald Trump for focusing
good
on it. He has a colorful way of speaking.
Good for you. If Ted Cruz spoke like Donald Trump, he'd be president. Ted Cruz is hindered by a Weasley voice. Unfortunately, he doesn't have the voice, the pipes for it. He's a good man. He's smart. Harvard Law, very, very good, very intelligent, good positions, but he can't win. Trump can win. Trump is bigger than life. Trump is a showman in addition to being a businessman, and those are the qualities necessary to take the country back. And I think he does represent Americans' values on this issue of illegals jumping the border and overrunning the nation, whether it's to simply take advantage of the fat of the land and drink the milk and enjoy the honey that we work for, or to commit crimes. It's irrelevant. The fact is that we cannot support as many illegals that are coming over the border. We never could. We never will. The lifeboat is sinking. We're all drowning. And it's time to build a wall, period. End of story. That's how I see it. This is not a new issue for me. I've owned this issue since I entered radio in 1994. And I've tried my best. Believe me, I've tried my best to stop this flood. And where have I gotten? It's only gotten worse. So all I can do is report what I see to be the truth and tell you about who actually did this to us. Who did the murder the other day is clearly the man who picked up the gun and shot that young lady. And although he pulled the trigger, there are those in the city who are culpable for the crime as accessories to this murder. And those would be the politicians who gave us the sanctuary law to begin with. And I think I would be remiss not to play a tape of a man I consider to be a very nice man, but he made a huge mistake in passing the sanctuary law. His name is Gavin Newsom, an all-around nice, good liberal man who's well-meaning. But as you well know, the road to you nowhere is paved with good intentions. In this case, the sanctuary city law has resulted not only in this murder, but in the murder of the Bologna family and others. Listen to Gavin then.
We're going to spend resources and time and energy and to do PSAs, to do campaign outreach into community clinics, into our public schools, into our police stations, to let people know what a sanctuary city is all about. We will stand up and fight for people so that they live their lives out loud in the light of day with dignity and respect.
Well, he lived his life out loud the other day. It was a very loud with three bangs from his gun. That was he got dignity out of that, too. Look at that. He's on the news. Look at that, who KGO TV is covering. A filthy murderer in a jail cell, kissing his behind with an interpreter, feeding him the answers so he looks like he's sorry. They had to tell him, say you're sorry. Mr. Whatever, are you sorry? Yeah, I'm sorry. Where'd you get the gun? The gun, yeah, the gun. I found it under the bench. Yeah, I found the gun under the bench. Well, what were you doing with the gun? Shooting sea lions. Who gave him that crap? All you genius liberals. You believe that? Are you crazy? Are you nuts? Mike on WBAP, welcome to the Savage Nation. What's on your mind, Mike?
Hey, Mike, it's an honor to talk with you. First off, I left the job a while ago, and they said you were on for that third hour, and then it ran off the road. I was so happy.
Oh, that's so good. And Texas is one of my favorite places on earth. I'm a misplaced Texan. Unfortunately, I was born in New York. But my sympathies lie with Texas. You know, I got to say this, Paul. We were told that federal immigration law controls immigration law, that states and cities cannot enact their own immigration law. Well, San Francisco is boldly saying that they have the right to pass their own immigration law in sanctuary cities. Why doesn't Dallas pass an immigration law which says, we're going to pass a law which says if you're found here illegally, you commit a felony, we're going to deport you with a state-owned bus. We're going to take you over the border and leave you in the desert. Why doesn't the state of Texas do that?
Sad part is, Michael, like everywhere else, the big cities are kind of run by the liberals. It's the people in the country that keep it conservative.
I know. They penetrated every office in every city, every university in every American city and town and village has been run over by these illegitimate anti-American forces. I know that. It's as though an invasion has occurred and they have won the civil war against the people themselves, which is why people have such a low regard for the politicians. But let's get back to the fact that I am on the air across America and especially now in hour number three on WBAP. Mike, I assume, therefore, you had been listening in earlier days in hours one and two?
Yes, sir. I usually go to work at 6 and get off in 2, and you're just hitting the radio when I hit my car, and I usually sit in my car in the driveway and listen to all of you.
Well, that's so great, man. I'm sending you a copy of my novel, which I'm sure you'll love, Countdown to Mecca, if you haven't already bought it. It's a very stirring, testosterone-driving novel that warns America about the sleeper cells of Muslims in America and around the world, ready to strike. Incidentally, thank God the intelligence agencies were lying to us last week, as I told you they were. When I heard Dianne Feinstein, ooh, all the chatter says they're liable to strike. When I heard all of them saying the same thing, I knew they were reading a script put out by one of the girls in the sorority, telling, all right, look, let's see, there haven't been any terrorist attacks, and look, the budget's trillions of dollars. We got to do something for the jerks out there who are paying the bills for the guns and the bullets and the trips and the investigations we don't do. Let's see. DHS alone is $2 billion a year. Who knows what? All right, let's put out a warning about July 4th when the jerks are going out for fireworks. Let's tell them we have high warnings, lots of chatter. There's likely to be an attack on July 4th. So right away, there's Feinstein. There's by the way, where'd they come up with the same script? I said to you Thursday there was going to be no attack. It sounded like rubbish to me. Thank God I was right. Thank God I could read the tea leaves. And I did. And thank God there was no attack. No doubt they'll tell us that they stopped 53 attacks while you were enjoying bacon and eggs. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
My Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com, the only company I trust to protect my wealth with gold and silver. Call 800-BUY-COIN. So you got a basket case called Greece. They live on the welfare, basically, of Germany and France. Fake disability claims. They don't want to work. They have no products. I mean, really, as I say, it's not about the Greek people, but let's face it. Greece is the Detroit of the world in that sense. They want everyone else to support them. What did they export? Baklava? Honey? Olive oil? I mean, forget about it. You know, if you eat baklava in too high a quantity, you don't want to sleep with any covers on your body. That's as far as I want to go. They're liable to find you asphyxiated in the morning. But aside from that bad joke, the fact is they don't produce enough products to survive. I don't understand how they expect the world to support them. But America's not too far behind. If you look at the dynamics of the American economy, you'll find out that we need a bailout. We need a bailout primarily because the liberals print money in order to buy votes. And this cannot go on. It's unsustainable. I love the liberals use a phrase, not sustainable. That was popular for a while. That's like the word gravitas 5 years ago. Not sustainable. What's not sustainable is an economy that has 95 million people not working in it, living on federal assistance. What's not sustainable are 13 million people on federal disability payments. What's not sustainable is something like 50 or 60 million illegal aliens who do not pay taxes, who are enjoying the milk and honey of the land in which they have invaded. That's what's not sustainable. What's not sustainable are the budgets of the federal, state, and local governments and the pensions. In fact, if you were to factor in the pensions of American federal, state, and local workers, America has been bankrupt for a very long time. We are Greece, only we don't know it. We are Greece with an Air Force, which is why we are not going to go bankrupt. Because anybody tries to take something from us, Obama's liable to use the Air Force for the first time. This is the Savage Nation. When I come back, more about the horrible tragedy in San Francisco, where we will hear from the murderer himself admitting he killed that young lady who died in her father's arms, saying, "Daddy, Daddy, save me." It's a heartbreaker.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
So who did this to us? Well, there's a lot of names. Gavin Newsom, Kamala Harris. We have a district attorney who did it. Now we learn that Francisco Sanchez, whatever his name is, was deported five times, had seven felony convictions. And the current DA, Mirakrami, whatever his name is, a guy who was once indicted for beating up his wife. And then he rigged the system, in my opinion. Now he's, believe it or not, sheriff again. Here's a guy who was involved in domestic abuse and wound up sheriff in San Francisco. It doesn't get any better. He's proud of the fact that he releases illegal aliens on a sanctuary policy. And they don't even apologize for what happened. I've been doing this for 21 years. Do you think anything is going to change? Do you think that the illiberal bastards who are in power, because of the millions of illegal aliens that they have cultivated as voters, because the taxpayers hate their guts, you think the taxpayers don't know about the corruption? So the taxpayers hate the politicians. So what did the politicians do, the evil, corrupt politicians? They import millions of illegal aliens who vote for them because the unions show them how to vote. Then they bastardize the voting process and say it's racist to require the language English in order to vote. And they make the ballot in six or seven languages in San Francisco to make sure the corruption can roll on and the potholes not be filled. So let's play for you. Very nice man. I consider him a very nice man. I ran into him in a restaurant not too long ago. I like the guy. But he owns this one. Here is none other than former Mayor Gavin Newsom on his boasting about the sanctuary city. Listen.
We're going to spend resources and time and energy and to do PSAs, to do campaign outreach into community clinics, into our public schools, into our police stations, to let people know what a sanctuary city is all about. We will stand up and fight for people so that they live their lives out loud in the light of day with dignity and respect.
Well, Mr. Sanchez Ramirez lived his life out loud, Mr. Newsom. In fact, he lived his life out loud with three shots. Everyone can hear him. claims that the sleeping pills did it. Then he says he found the gun under the bench. Then he said he was shooting sea lions, which unto itself is a federal offense and a state offense. Not one word from the liars at PETA about an illegal alien shooting at sea lions. Is that a cultural defense? That in Mexico they're allowed to shoot sea lions? I don't really know. I'll have to look into that. So he's shooting at sea lions and he accidentally shoots this young lady in front of her father. And as she's dying in her father's arms, she says, "Daddy, Daddy, help me. Daddy, help me. It cut me to the core. Could be you. It's two blocks from where I live in San Francisco. I walk there on a regular basis. In fact, I went there yesterday to look at the place. And not too far away, there was a group of people giving out flyers on dogs in cages being held upside down by their feet with their throats being cut for the South Korean dog meat trade. Torturing dogs, killing dogs, eating dogs, the meat market in South Korea. They're doing a good job. But there was nobody, surprisingly, talking about the illegal aliens with guns and knives in San Francisco. The liberals are worried about dogs. I don't blame them. I love dogs. Now, it's very easy to jump on this story and say that all Mexicans are murderers and rapists. That's absurd. We all know that's a lie, and let's not go there. It diminishes this crime and this tragic murder. It does point out, though, what a sanctuary city will do, because it's done it before. Now, let me turn the clock back in time for you, because several years ago, there was another very tragic murder in this sanctuary city. It was a triple murder. On June 22nd, 2008, Edwin Ramos, an illegal alien with a long history of violence, executed Tony Bologna, age 48, and his sons Michael 20 and Matthew 16 in front of their mother. Edwin Ramos thought one of the Bologna sons was a gang rival. Did you hear that one? Now, I was deeply hurt by that murder. And I raised money for Mrs. Bologna, which I sent to her a fund. But that's a side note. Believe me, I've been involved in this a long time. You remember that one? Raise your hands if you remember the last illegal, sensational illegal murder story. I was on the radio June 22nd, 2008. Edwin Ramos, an illegal alien who, by the way, had been arrested for murder before and released. A gang member released by the city of San Francisco, right? Came upon this family, made a wrong turn in an alley, Tony Bologna and his sons Michael and Matthew. They made a wrong turn, and this piece of human trash executed them in the car. Remember that story? Ramos was a suspected illegal alien border jumper from El Salvador. And he was barred from deportation, even though he had committed a gang-related assault and an attempted robbery. Do you know who stopped him from being deported? It was then District Attorney Kamala Harris, who is now the Attorney General of the state of California. It was Kamala Harris who did that. Was she punished for that? Did she lose her career for that? No, because she's part of the Willie Brown machine. She was then anointed to a higher position. The entire state is corrupt from top to bottom. There is no crime that can be committed that will ever be punished in this state, unless it's loving the country and the flag. That's the only crime, and homophobia. Those are the only crimes that will be punished in this twisted upside down city. So there's a lot to talk about in the Savage Nation. And I want to go back to my writings on the war on our borders, language, and culture. In my last book, Before Countdown to Mecca, called Stop the Coming Civil War. It looks to me like I should revise it and take out the word stop, because it looks to me like only a civil war can save America. They are at war with this country. Obama has flooded 125,000 Africans into St. Paul, Minnesota. Why would he do that? Why would he bring 125,000 Africans to St. Paul, Minnesota, when they don't speak English, they don't know what the culture is, they've never used a toothbrush, they've never used toilet paper? Why would he bring them there? What is he trying to do to this country? Why is he dumping most third worlders in white cities and white communities and white towns? You're telling me this is not a civil war conducted by this monster Frankenstein? You're wrong. So there's a lot to talk about here. And the only one saying it is Donald Trump. And of course, he's being smeared by the vermin in the media. That's to be expected. That's all they're capable of, those useless idiots, always on the wrong side of things. And then, of course, there's Romney attacking him. Rubio, the ice cream man, attacking him. Rick Perry attacking him. All of the jerks who would not come on my show, by the way. You know why they wouldn't come on my show? Because they knew where I stood on illegal aliens. And we know what they're worth. You know what they're worth? They're worth zero. They're less than zero. They are less than zero. Romney, Perry, Rubio. I told you who they were. And so the only one who stood up for him is Cruz, to his credit. He would not attack him. Good for him. If you've listened to my show, The Savage Nation, you know the importance I place on the preservation of our borders, language, and culture. And you know that this administration has done more to further the left's war against America by attempting to destroy these three foundation blocks of our republic than any other administration in our history. When I speak to you about protecting our borders, language, and culture, I speak to you as a first-generation American. I am an immigrant son. My ancestors didn't come over on the Mayflower. They came over from Russia in third-class steerage. They worked hard and died young. They learned to speak English and they learned America's ways. They got on the back of the bus. They didn't demand that they take over the bus and drive it into a wall. They were true American immigrants. But the immigrants of the past are not the same as the immigrants today. I understand that the situation is different now than it was nearly 100 years ago, but the fundamentals of immigration are the same. You come as a guest and then muster up every ounce of compliance and determination you can until you earn your full-time status. This is not the immigration formula under the current administration. Their idea of immigration is to grant amnesty to those who have crossed our borders illegally. The true demagogues are Barack Obama, the Attorney General, the head of ICE, the mayor of San Francisco in this case, the sheriff of San Francisco, the ex-mayor of San Francisco, and all the others, Kamala Harris, who played a role in making this city safe for illegal aliens. They did so for political reasons, in order to maintain power in their office, maintain their office, and maintain power, because they know that the average citizen who works and lives in San Francisco is on to their corruption and their incompetence, and wouldn't vote for them, so they imported an entire population of illegals to keep them in power, is my estimation. So who do you blame? Can you blame all the people of Mexico? That would be crazy. That'd be like saying all Americans are fat and take pills the way Al Jazeera did. You can't do that. It's not correct. So we have to stay focused on who did this to us and try our best to unravel the sanctuary city policy, not only in San Francisco. I have a list of all the major cities that are sanctuary cities, because most of these, like Detroit, are obviously sanctuary cities because they need them as voters. You understand that? How do you think a communist like de Blasio in New York seized power? Through the illegal alien vote, through the unions. That's how. So the fact of the matter is, all we can do is point it out and talk about it. But I have been on the front lines of this battle for 21 years since I entered radio. In fact, as I said to you, a number of years ago when I spoke out about the Ramos murders of the Bologna family and then spoke out against the Dreamers, they boycotted my local station. A mob came, a union-controlled mob, and they had T-shirts on condemning Michael Savage. You don't know about this. I didn't make a big issue of it. But they tried to drive me out of the city. Here I am, a distinguished member of the city, being attacked by hordes, armies of illegal aliens who have been encouraged by the corrupt politicians. We don't want immigration reform. We want comprehensive government reform. We'd like to see all of them thrown out of office. But take a look at who's waiting in the wings. Jeb Bush. Jeb Bush attacked Trump, didn't he? Trump is the only one who can save us, incidentally. However, by the time Trump became president, I can guarantee you his position would change. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
The Savage Nation is sponsored by Swiss America, the only company I trust with my financial future. Call 800-289-2646 or SwissAmerica.com.
Kate Steinling, the lady who was down on Pier 14?
Yes.
You did shoot her. Mm-hmm. Where did you get the gun?
In the ground, when that's over there in the bench, I put my leg and I see the one teacher and then see over there, something like that. That's when I hear that boom, boom, three times.
Boom, 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 like chocolat. So let's see, he was shooting at sea lions. He found the gun. I'm surprised San Francisco hasn't given Lopez Sanchez an award for culling the sea lion population. And I'm waiting for the mayor of San Francisco to give the illegal alien Mexican murderer a prize for culling the bay of evil sea lions. So everyone's to blame. The sleeping pills made him sleepy. The gun was found under the bench. He was only killing sea lions, which is unbelievable because a violation of state and federal law. He should be arrested for that. Immediately deported for that, for killing sea lions. Not one word from the animal rights liars. But he kills a beautiful young woman in front of a father. The father tries to help her. The girl screams, daddy, help me, and she dies in his arms. And now the reporters from KGO television go there and coax him into expressing regret for killing the woman. I'm not buying any of it. He didn't find the gun under the bench. Any homicide detective would tell you that's rubbish. What do you have to be, Sherlock Holmes, to understand this is all a lie? Oh, no, 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 no. He went there, in my opinion, with the intent to kill someone for a gang initiation. That's as highly likely as any explanation for why he killed this woman randomly. Don't tell me he was shooting at sea lions. That's number one. That's what I would investigate if we had a rational city. Listen, this whole topic that we're talking about is a topic I've been talking about for 21 years. We all heard the story by now. Even the most unconscious, dumb Democrat voter in San Francisco is saying, "Ooh, that's terrible. The man from killed that girl on the wharf. That's not good." But them right-wingers are going to exploit it against all Mexicans. It's that Donald Trump who really is the bad guy. The reporters were nicer to this murderer than they are to Donald Trump. And let me tell you something else. They're nicer to this illegal alien murderer than they were to me. You don't know this, and I'm not going to make it about me. It's too easy to do. Because I've been on this topic since I began in radio. One book after another, I've talked about the alien invasion. One book after another, I've talked about the war on our borders. But the fact of the matter is, when I was on another local station in San Francisco, the mobs, stirred up by La Raza and the other hate groups, had a mob of illegal Mexicans and Central Americans outside the radio station demanding that I be fired because all I did say was, no, they're not dreamers and they don't belong in my country. They're here illegally. That was enough for them to demand I be fired. So don't think I haven't been on the front lines of this war for a long time, but what good has it done? So who is to blame for the killing of this woman, the murder of this woman? There's a lot of blame to go around, and we're going to play things for you, and you'll decide who's to blame. This is in Gavin Newsom's backyard. Gavin Newsom is no longer mayor, but Gavin Newsom was once mayor, and Gavin Newsom boasted about this being a sanctuary city, and we have that for you on tape. Nancy Pelosi, I'm surprised she hasn't gone to the prison to wash the blood off Sanchez's hands. After all, she washed the filth off the feet of the children who were brought in last summer. Wasn't she the one washing their feet? Why doesn't she go to the jailhouse and wash the blood off Lopez Sanchez's hands? Why doesn't Dianne Feinstein take some credit for this murder? Why doesn't the district attorney take some credit for this murder? There's a lot of blame to go around, by the way. And if you think San Francisco is the only sanctuary city, I'll have a list of all major sanctuary cities for you. And there's a reason that these cities, Anchorage, Alaska, Fairbanks, Alaska, Chandler, Arizona, Phoenix, Arizona, Fresno, California, Los Angeles, California, San Diego, San Francisco. I'll list all of them for you. Do you know why they have made their city sanctuary cities? Do you think the cynical, corrupt politicians who are robbing the treasuries blind in these cities give a damn about illegal aliens? It's because the tax-paying citizens hate their guts. The tax-paying citizens know that they're corrupt, no-good gangsters, and they wouldn't vote for them. So by bringing in millions upon millions of illegal aliens, the illiberals are all kept in power by non-citizen voters. Do you get that? Do you understand what I'm saying to you? If it was not for the illegal alien voter population in San Francisco, we would not have this corrupt regime running San Francisco. Was it not for the illegal alien voter population in California, we would not have this corrupt government running the state out of Sacramento.
Savage.